So we're going to demonstrate the Kirby G5. This is the carpet shampoo system. I don't know if you can get a close-up of that. I didn't really get into details on how to hook it up. There's a lot of videos out there that show you how to do that, so I'm not really getting into that. Just a small rug here. Honestly, this system's pretty much a gimmick. It's more for just fluffing a carpet and making it smell pretty is pretty much all it does. So let me get back up on the rug, and we're going to go ahead and turn it on. So basically, once you have your Kirby dry foam solution in the tank there, we got it filled up to the second line. So I believe I put 2 capfuls of the dry foam solution. Got your hose going to the front with the brush and everything attached. Want to make sure it's turned to the open position, or on, it should say. Let me make sure I did, yeah. And basically what you want to do is just go in nice, even strokes so that you're, you know, foaming the carpet up. So go ahead and flick it on, everything's plugged in, everything's attached. So as you go forward, it lays down some of the solution, but when you pull back, that's when you get the foam. So you want to cover the whole area in foam. Once it's foamed, you're going to go ahead and switch your foam off and then just go in multiple different directions to agitate the rug. And what it does is the dry foam actually gets down into the carpet and it helps attach itself to the dirt and allergens or whatever else is in the rug. And it basically helps to lift it as it dries. So the dirt and the debris will attach to the foam. So once it dries after several hours, then you can vacuum it, and that's actually what pulls up the dirt. If you're looking to scrub your carpets, get rid of stains, things like that, this is honestly not the system you want to use. An actual carpet extractor to do this. This is more for just freshening up your rugs in between shampoos, in my opinion. So we'll go ahead and flick the unit on. I got it in the auto drive mode. much gives you the general idea. We're gonna just have a towel on hand because, as you can see, this machine makes a mess. But it smells really good. It's like a lavender flavor. I don't have the bottle, unfortunately. I threw it out, but it says Kirby on it. You can order on Amazon. It seems to be the cheapest place, or get it directly from Kirby. Like I said, not really a stain lifter per se. It's more of just allergies and just a freshen your rug. It's really not going to do anything other than that for you. It's just kind of give you a little bit of a fresh smell and get some of the surface dirt out of the rug. If you really want to deep clean, like I said, you want to use an actual carpet extractor. But this is a Kirby G5 system. Got on eBay. I think I spent like $46 for it, for the system, and it just attaches right to the front. Uses the same belt as your actual nozzle does for vacuuming. So this is your nozzle with your classic little belt lifter lever. So it uses the same belt. So, and it attaches on just like this does, and then it gives you the ability to agitate, and it turns the, because the tank is hooked up where the bag is normally hooked up to, it actually basically turns into a blower. So it basically foams the liquid into the carpet. So like I said, that's pretty much it. Don't really have anything else to say about it. This is a February of 1997 model. I actually got this in the trash and cleaned it up. Didn't come with any of the attachments. Did pick up these attachments here. A friend of my mom's, Donna, she actually gave these to me. So I'm kind of excited to start using some of them over the summertime. Like working in, you know, cleaning the car and stuff like that. And also I want to get a zip brush as well. Because those are really good for cleaning different types of carpeted and upholstery service or surfaces in the car and whatnot. So that's it. Like I said, that's your G5 shampooer. That's what it looks like when it's in operation. That's the generally how you want to work the machine, is first lay down the foam and then go back over and agitate it until you don't see any more foam. And then just use a towel and clean up the rest. take everything off, rinse everything out with cool water in the sink. And then you definitely want to let it dry before you put it back in the box or store it away. And like I said, there are videos out there that shows you all the individual pieces and how to hook it up, is including on Kirby's website. You can get the video too. So not my typical car video, but hopefully somebody out there finds this interesting and helpful. Thanks for watching.